What is this book to you? If you're watching online, you might just open up your chat and type in your answer to that. Are you in the strange and odd category? It's just an unfamiliar book to you. Is it like a history book? It's just something to be studied, no different perhaps than other books. Or is it a source of spiritual power? Last week, we started our step series saying that our faith journey begins in understanding how our story fits within God's story. Well, for that faith to continue to grow and develop, we have to understand God's story. We have to understand the Bible and realize that it is an indispensable resource for spiritual development. That is what Paul wrote to his young protege Timothy to remind him. He encouraged him to keep learning the scriptures as he had been taught as a young boy by his mother. Keep growing and learning the Bible. And then Paul shares these words that are so important for how we might read the Bible today. He says, all scripture is God-inspired. All scripture is God-inspired. Now, some people take that to mean that God literally reached God's hand out of heaven and wrote on paper the words that we now have in the Bible, or that God took a hold of the hands of those who wrote scripture and literally dictated each word that's there. And they say that's how we are to read the Bible. Every word comes from God. It's to be interpreted just as it is. But is that how Paul means for scripture to be read? Is that how we're to understand the Bible? Let's look a little closer at what Paul says. The word inspired is the Greek word theopneustos. Theopneustos. It comes from two words, theo, meaning God, and pneustos, which you might recognize as sounding familiar to words like pneumonia or pneumatic. It literally means wind, spirit, breath. So literally what Paul is saying here is all scripture is God-breathed. Now notice he puts it in the present tense, not the past tense. He doesn't say all scripture was God-breathed. It is God-breathed. In other words, God breathes upon the scripture, upon those who wrote the words. And then God breathes upon it again whenever scripture is read so that we understand its meaning for our lives today. So when you think about how we read the Bible, it starts to challenge that idea that we simply read it literally. Think of it this way. Think of the story of creation when God made Adam. God formed Adam out of the dust of the earth. So there's a physical body. But when did Adam truly have life? When God breathed into Adam. Paul says this is what God does with scripture. God breathes. God gives spirit and direction upon those who wrote. And then God breathes upon us when we hear it. And it gives spiritual life to us. So if you think about it, to say that the Bible is to be interpreted literally, that that's exactly how God wrote it, then what need would there be for God to continue breathing life upon the words? If they were once breathed upon, what more help do we need? Now we've got it. Just follow what it says. Do what it says. But Paul says it is inspired. We continue to need God's help to understand these words and to study them, to learn them, and let it speak to us.